lot of people ask me if you can do this from inside your house, which you easily can, but it depends how easily you can see the thing. Because you could tell even from where the camera is, you really can't see what's going on right around the machine. And with snow, it's hard to tell, like, I don't know how deep it is right now, what I'm going through. Also, it's really hard to see the line that I was just running down to go back to it, you know. But if your window in your house is, like, right next to your driveway, you could easily do it from inside. But our driveway is fairly long. And also it depends on if your driveway is really steep, you might have a harder time using this machine because it really depends on traction. But with a steep driveway, you could always, you know, do the passes just downwards and then drive back up through the clean area. It'd take a little longer, but it you know, it'd still work. My driveway is definitely not steep, but even this small incline makes it so you have to just work or think about what you're doing a little more to keep the traction. So now that there's not too much snow left, I can actually increase the speed, because you want to. That's another thing about when you're inside the house, you can't hear the motor, so you can't hear if it's like work, you know, really bogging down. You could put like some crazy first-person camera system on this with a mic, which would be pretty sweet. And also right here where the curb is that I just went up, there's a slight curb there. It's hard to keep the blower trim as you're going up over the curb. See, like I had it really high to get up the curb, and now it's too high, so then I lowered it back down. And then when the machine came back to being level, it was a little too low then. So you have to continuously adjust the height. But once you get the hang of it, it goes pretty easily. And I can see that the raising mechanic is a little clogged again, so I'm gonna go clear it. Oops, I accidentally unplugged the light while I swept that away. But I have all those things on the chute on plugs, so in case you do turn it too far, it will just unplug itself. That says just temporary until I can figure out a 360 degree method. And also it doesn't hurt to clear off some of the snow around the motor, just to let it not get so warm. And also, if I was in my house, I wouldn't be able to see this giant snowbank that I'm going into, like right at the curb. So, you know, if you enter the snow too fast, you could potentially fill the chute up with too much snow, so it just clogs on you. Like, see that snowbank there? I should have had the auger on. But yeah, hopefully me talking through while I'm driving can kind of help people, you know, figure out how to operate the thing. Because it, you know, there's really nothing else like it out there for people to you know how to use it already. I think I accidentally had the blower too high up in the air there. I went up over a little snow pile right here. Yep. And one thing is you can't really set the snowblower height to just one fixed thing, because depending on how you're driving and how your driveway is, you always have to be adjusting it. But it's easy to do, you know, you just flick the joystick up or down to raise it or lower it a little bit. See, I think maybe one more pass should probably do it. Yep, see right here, I'm having a really hard time with getting traction. That's actually our front yard right there, where the cement ends. So I might be hanging off the side of it or something. But in this case, since I'm going up the hill, I'm gonna go ahead and just drive the machine back up. And then turn around and do it downhill, because you have a lot more traction going downhill. This is a really deep part of snow right here too. Yeah, I would say that's pretty good for my driveway. Like I said earlier, I didn't get down to the pavement just because I missed it the last few snowfalls, so it kind of iced up. No snowblower would get down to our pavement at the moment. But I'm gonna go and try my neighbors, and if their pavement's better, I'll film a little bit more. But it only took about 12 minutes to clear this whole part of the driveway, so it's not too much slower than using a big gas blower. Definitely a lot funner. So here's at my neighbors. You can see it does go down to the pavement pretty much. I could probably lower the bar just a little bit, but their driveway is a lot better kept than mine. And also you can hear the sound of gas snowblowers all around me, which do better than this thing, but not by too much. This thing still does pretty good for what it is, for sure.